This is what the typical GameMaker interface looks like. At the top, we have the name of the currently open project, and right after it is the name of the version. Below it is the main menus. We have File, Edit, Resources, Scripts, Run, Window, and Help. Just below that, we have the main toolbar. On it, we have Create a New Game. This will create a new project for you to start working within. Open an existing game. This will obviously allow you to open a previous game you've been working on. Save the current game. So this will save the current game you're working on. This will finalize your game, creating a standalone copy that has a file type associated with the target you've selected from the drop-down menu over here. Then we have Run the Game. When you've created a game, this will allow you to test what you're working on. Next to it, we have Run Game in Debug Mode. This will do the same as Run the Game, except it'll open up an additional window for debugging purposes. Next to that, we have Stop Web Server. This button will be used to cancel the compilation of your games to the target module, or, on certain targets only, to stop the game while it is running after it has been compiled. Next to that, we have the icon for Clear Project Asset Compile Cache. Every time you save or test your game, your assets are compiled into a cache, but over time, the cache may become corrupted. This button allows you to clear set cache, and it's a good idea to do this before you finalize your game for whatever platform you're planning to finalize it for. The next section of the main toolbar deals with creating assets for your current project. The first icon creates a sprite. After that, we can create a sound, create a background, create a path, create a script, create a shader, create a font, create a timeline, create an object, and create a room. The next section has an icon for changing the global game settings and selecting an extension package to use. The question mark icon is for showing help on GameMaker. Next to that, we have the compile target. There's a drop-down menu that allows you to select which platform you'd like to output your game to, be it Windows, Mac, HTML5, iOS, Android, or a whole slew of others. Depending on your version of GameMaker, you may have to purchase additional modules to compile to some of the aforementioned targets. After the Compile Target drop-down menu, your main toolbar may vary depending on which version of GameMaker you have and whether or not you've received it from Steam. For instance, next to the Compile Target, you may have a drop-down for configurations. This drop-down allows you to compile your game slightly differently depending on which target you're compiling to. There's also a Manage button to allow you to change your configurations. If you've received your copy of GameMaker through Steam, you might see the buttons Play, Workshop, and New IDE. The Play button allows you to open up Steam Workshop games that you've subscribed to on Steam and then play them. The Workshop button will take you to the Steam Workshop associated with GameMaker. The New IDE button will open up a second instance of GameMaker. And last, you may have a Knowledge Base text field. You can type in any information associated with GameMaker, press Enter, and you'll be taken to the Yo-Yo Games website with the associated information. On the left side of the screen, you'll find your resource tree. This is where all the assets for your game will be held. The first folder holds your sprites. Sprites are images that can either be one frame or full animations that will later become objects for your game. The sounds folder will hold your sounds and background music. The backgrounds folder will hold images that don't become objects and therefore non-interactable. The paths folder holds paths for your objects to follow when in-game. The scripts folder holds your scripts, which are snippets of code that can be called upon by any object in your game. The shaders folder holds your shaders, which can change the way your game looks. They can add cool effects to your games, like blurring, scan lines, water effects, but it's pretty advanced, so we'll get into that later. The next folder holds your fonts. It holds fonts that you can later turn into text in your game to write things like high score. The next folder, timelines, holds advanced alarm clocks. We'll talk about alarms later though. The next window could possibly be one of the most important ones. It's objects. Objects hold pretty much all the code in your game and consist of all interactable objects. This could be your player, enemies, a wall. As long as it's interactable, it goes in the objects folder. The next folder is rooms. This is like levels for your game, Or really, any time you change screens. It could be your title screen, it could be your options screen, it could be level 32, it could be a forest. But this is where all your rooms, or levels, or screens will be held. The next folder is called Included Files. This will house additional files that will be included with your game at the compile target step. The next folder is Extensions. This will hold outside code that you've added to your game. It could be GML code, which is GameMaker language, which is what GameMaker uses and will be learning. It could be JavaScript, or it could be DLL. Below that, we have a folder called Constants. We'll have to get into that later once you understand variables. Below the folders, you'll find two icons, one called Game Information. If you double-click on Game Information, it'll open up something similar to WordPad or Notepad. It's a rich text editor. In here, you can write down any information for the game, or bugs you're currently working on, whatever you want. It won't actually be included with the game when you compile it. It's simply notes for your own reference. The last icon is Global Game Settings. When you double-click on that, you'll get a settings window, and inside, it'll have a bunch of options that allow you to change how your game functions depending on the compile target. It's very important that you set this up early in your game-making process, but we'll go into that later. The big empty area on the right is called your workspace. This should be where all your windows open up, so you can make adjustments to whatever, sprites, objects, rooms, constants. It's your workspace. It's where you do your work. Finally, we have the Compile Messages window. This will show you your compile information whenever you test your game or compile your game. It may not be open by default, and you may not need it open all the time, but it will open whenever you run or compile your game. It can freely float, or it can be snapped to the bottom of your workspace.